You're watching RHN Special Report with host Neilan Baptiste.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to RHN Special Report. It's no surprise that ever since the 1980s, Brooklyn has become home to an increasingly vibrant and populous Caribbean community. Nowadays, it's not all too uncommon to see outdoor barbecue or blasting soca music. In fact, on September 20, 2017, NYC designated its first ever Little Caribbean District. Its streets are lined with local shops selling traditional products and eateries like Back Home Bakery, Neo's Roti Shop, and Bacon Things, selling delicious Caribbean treats and pastries. Conceived as an effort to protect the rapidly gentrifying community's unique history, this district has become a cultural mecca for all those who want to lime and get back to the aisles. The food alone is enough, and it has most of what you would find in a good cultural district and tourist destination. It's easy to get to. It has many utilities like convenience stores and fast food. Many major stores have outlets here like Rite Aid and Chase. And there are lots of entertainment and things to do. So what's the problem? Well, like other cities such as Miami, Chicago, and Philly, New York has a large Haitian population. Haitians have been living in the city since the early days of both the U.S. and Haiti. But, in a strange twist, the city does not have a district to celebrate this rich cultural group, instead lumping it together with the aforementioned Little Caribbean District. A concept for a district celebrating the borough's Haitians has gone back a full decade, but sadly they've all hit brick walls and have essentially been talked to death in Senate. For many, the issue was solved with the creation of the Little Caribbean, and for many years there was no mention of a Haiti district at all. However, Assemblywoman Rodneyse thought differently. After arguing in the district's favor for years, Ti Ayiti, Haitian Creole for Little Haiti, is finally becoming a reality. The new district, which spans Flatbush Avenue between Empire Boulevard and Nostrand Avenue, Church Avenue between Flatbush and New York Avenues, and Nostrand Avenue between Flatbush Avenue and Empire Boulevard, also comes with signs and landmarks to denote when you've entered and left its boundaries. But those celebrating Bichotte's victory also understand that it has a long fight to get to this point. To get more of an insight on what it took for Ti Ayiti to become a reality, I sat down with New York State Senator Kevin Parker in his Tilden Avenue District office. So, Senator, tell us a little bit about yourself.
First of all, welcome to my district office and thank you for taking this time. I'm State Senator Kevin Parker. I represent the 21st District here in Brooklyn, which is part of Canarsie and part of Flatlands, but principally East Flatbush and Flatbush, Midwood, Ditmas Park, and Windsor Terrace at Park Slope. I'm the Democratic Whip in the New York State Senate, as well as the ranking member on Energy and Telecommunications. I have been serving in this post, this is actually my 16th year, and I'm really proud and honored to have the opportunity because I've actually grown up in this community for over 40 years, having gone to Haiti Junior High School, Midwood High School, Toy at Brooklyn College, and you know, generally have loved this community.
I've heard it's not uncommon to see you leading a local cleanup, attending local events, or just walking around town interacting with the community. Do you believe this involvement is what separates you from other politicians?
Well, I'm not sure that I'm any different than most of my colleagues. I think all of us live here in the community. You will see us interacting just like every other citizen. We do a job fair every year. I do prom dress giveaways.
Oh yes, we're donating prom dresses to high school students.
Yep, and we did about 200 prom dresses a couple of weeks ago, and as well as men's suits for the first time. A prom can be a very expensive event for families. It could be up to $1,000, and so we certainly want to help defray the cost of that. But we do lots of events. We do a back to school event. We do free flu shots. Do a lot of events with seniors, including fall prevention events. And so we think that is a good way for this office to serve and to address the needs of everyone, in not just the 21st District, but in the community in general.
When and how did you become involved with the Ti Ayiti project?
Well, I've gotten involved with this project probably over the last 6 or 7 months. My colleague in government, Assemblywoman Rodneyse Bichotte, came to me and told me how important it was that we get engaged. There's been some talk about it for a number of years. I've gotten involved. I've been attending the meetings. We had a really good meeting with the Commissioner of the Department of Transportation for the city and talked about signage, talked about archways, talked about traffic, street lights, and other kinds of things that we want to do.
What challenges did the new district face?
Well, the Little Haiti project has really faced a number of challenges, the first of which is just one of community buy-in. Not everyone agrees with it, to be honest with you, but more people agree with it than don't, and so that's part of what made us to go forward with it. We think that it's really going to improve the community in the context of marketing to the community in general, but particularly it's going to help the business community more than anything else. We also think that, again, the notion of community pride is going to be increased as people see some of the beautification improvements that we're planning and some of the historical monuments that we want to include as part of the new architecture of the community.
What are the benefits of such an historic district in the heart of Brooklyn? Are there any downsides?
Well, I don't think there's any downside. I think that when you look for an opportunity to market a community around its capital, that you enhance both the understanding but the historical antecedents of that community. But this is also, don't get it twisted, really an opportunity to make money for this community, to keep dollars in the community, because we want people to understand that you don't have to go to Manhattan or to other communities to get some of the things that you need, that we have a lot of really good entrepreneurs, a lot of good products, a lot of good services right here in this community. We want people to understand that, be proud of it, and more importantly, utilize and rotate their dollars in this community.
In fact, a lot of detractors have said that this part of the borough, despite being generally well known, does not have what it takes to compete with other areas like downtown Brooklyn or Coney Island or even Prospect Park. So what do you have to say to that argument?
Well, I think that you're absolutely right when the detractors have certainly made an argument that we're not as marketable as some other places, but I disagree. And Assemblywoman Rodneyse Bichotte also disagreed, and Councilman Jumaane Williams also disagreed. And so we thought that we would work on what we do agree on, that Little Haiti we thought was a valuable ethnic and historical commodity, and we thought that we could market it in a way in which we could stand proud and compete with other communities.
Finally, Senator Parker, what do you hope will be the future of this district? Do you think it will prosper for years, or will it be slowly forgotten like others?
No, I think the future of this community is actually very bright. And I think that over time, it's going to get even brighter. I think that young men like yourself growing up in this community and how poised and how well prepared you are evidence of that to me. And I think it's just the beginning. I think we're just touching the tip of the iceberg, really create some synergies between, the educational infrastructure of this community, the economic infrastructure, the political infrastructure, and to make all of them come together in order to have the kind of community that we not just are proud of, but the kind of community that we would like to continue to raise our families in. New York is full of ethnic enclaves, and I think all those enclaves should be proud of their heritage and their history. The Little Haiti Project is going to be the beginning of a resurrection and a deeper understanding of all the different ethnicities that make up this wonderful mosaic that we call New York City.
Well, thank you, Senator Parker.
No, thank you.
You know, despite all the challenges that Haitians and Haitian Americans have and continue to face at home and abroad, after spending some time in the community and learning from these beautiful, resilient people, I believe that the American public has them all wrong. Yes, Haiti is a very poor and unstable nation. It's always been that. But it also has one of the most culturally rich international communities I've ever seen. Depending on your definition of wealth, Haiti is a very rich nation, and I think that speaks volumes. And hopefully that rich cultural history will let this new cultural district prosper for many years to come. Special thanks to the NY Senate and the office of New York State Senator Parker. Reporting for RHN Special Report, I'm Neil Baptiste, and we will see you next time.